Hello students, myself Professor Ankur. I welcome everyone for the gate theory session of analog circuits. We are discussing an important topic from the topic of BJT. It's our sixth session and we're going to cover today BJT small signal analysis. So the topic for today is BJT small signal analysis. So let's start with the topic. So here, we are talking about BJT common emitter amplifier. So if you can see the left hand side figure carefully, we are having a BJT common emitter amplifier with fixed biased arrangement. The top voltage is VCC, the input side resistance as RB, the resistance for the collector as RC, the two coupling capacitors involved C1 and C2. The emitter terminal is shorted to ground. So we are giving the input to the base of the transistor with the help of a coupling capacitor on the input side, and we are taking output from the collector of the transistor with the help of the coupling capacitor C2. So when you look at the configuration, it will be common emitter configuration. So whenever we try to analyze the circuitry, the analysis part will be split up into two parts. The first will be the DC part and the second will be the AC part. So whenever we talk about the DC part, all the capacitors will work like open circuit. The voltage source will work like a short circuit. But since the input capacitor C1 is open, it doesn't actually matter what happens to your input VI. So the DC section of the circuitry, we are having a transistor with resistance RB, RC, VCC. So when I try to go for cable to the input loop, I can easily get the value of base current in the form of VCC minus VBE by RB. And when I go for cable to the output loop, you will get the value of VCE as VCC minus ICRC. You can get IC as beta times IB, which will help us in our calculation for the AC parameter or the components of the small signal AC model. So whether we go for the RE model, hybrid model, or hybrid pi model, accordingly, we can get the value of the device parameter. So suppose if I want to analyze the circuitry using the RE model. So when I go for the AC analysis, the first thing I have to do is I have to replace the device by its AC equivalent. So the AC equivalent is shown in the figure. We are having beta RE on the input side, a current source defined as beta IB, and the output resistance defined as RO. This is representing the transistor. Apart from that, we are going for the external elements. So whenever we go for the AC analysis, all the capacitors will work like short circuit and the DC battery will be as good as zero potential, because when we go for AC analysis, the DC source will get vanished. So vanished in the sense it will be shorted to ground. So now when we draw the equivalent circuitry, we are having at the input side a resistance defined as RB, and on the output side we are having the resistance defined as RC. So if I want to calculate the input resistance or input impedance of the network, the first impedance from the base will be measured as beta RE. And if I go to calculate ZI, it will be a parallel combination of RB and beta RE. So if the value of RB is very, very high compared to beta RE, the ZI can be estimated as beta RE. Similarly, on the output side, the output impedance can be measured as RO parallel capital RC, where if the RO value is much, much higher compared to the RC value, then the ZO can be estimated equal to RC. When we go for the calculation of voltage gain AV, you will get VO by VI. So on VO by VI calculation, we are left out with the term RC by RE with a minus sign. The minus sign basically indicates that the voltage gain of the amplifier is negative, implies the gain corresponds to a inverting amplifier. So whatever signal you give on the input side, it will get phase shifted by 180 degree along with the effect of amplification, and that will come on the output side. That's the significance of the minus sign in the voltage gain equation, because we are having two types of amplifier, inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier. So the minus sign indicates that it is a inverting amplifier. When I go for the current gain calculation, I have to go for a ratio of I0 by II. So when I go for I0 by II, the actual gain of the device is basically the beta, because it's a relation between IC and IB. But when I go for the network, I need to solve for the network as I'm trying to relate I0 with respect to II. So I0 is related to IC, IC is related to IB, and IB is related to II. So now when I go for the equations in terms of I0 and II, I will get relation I0 by IC into IC by IB into IB by II, where IC by IB will be shown in the form of beta, and the remaining factor can be realized in the form of a current divider rule. So overall, we land up at beta RB into RO divided by RO plus RC into RB plus beta RA. So if I go for an estimation, you will land up at AI value. So the value of AI can be also calculated in terms of the voltage gain AB. So AI can be seen in the form of minus of AB ZI by RC. Now, if I try to realize a BJT common emitter amplifier, in the BJT common emitter amplifier with a potential divider bias arrangement, you will find the input side having two resistances R1, R2. The output side is having a collector resistance of RC and an emitter resistance of RE. And there will be three capacitors C1, C2, and CE, where CE is basically an important factor that actually controls the gain, because CE is also controlling the impact of feedback that can be given through the RE resistance. So let's go for the understanding. When I go for the DC analysis will be the solving by representing the input side by its Thevenin's equivalent, and then going for the cable to the input and the cable to the output equation. So once you represent VCC R1, R2 by its ETH and RTH, and then when you apply KVL, you'll get the equation for IB as ETH minus VBE divided by RTH plus 1 plus beta times RE. This entire concept of converting into Thevenin and then applying KVL equation was already discussed when we have discussed the potential divider bias separately. Now, when I go for KVL to the output loop, we have VCC minus ICRC minus VCE minus IERE equal to 0, and solving, we get the value of VCE. So from this, we are actually interested in the value of IC, because IC is beta times IB, and that will help us in your calculation for the AC parameter elements. Whether we go for the RE model or hybrid pi model, it doesn't actually matter. We just need to pick up one model and we need to find an element corresponding to that model. So here it is representing the AC equivalent circuitry. So if you observe carefully, beta RE, beta IB and RO, they are actually representing the equivalent of the device. RC is on the output side, R1, R2 on the input side, and then we are having VI on the input side and VO on the output side. The input current is represented as II, input impedance as ZI, output current as IO, output impedance as ZO, VO corresponds to the output voltage, VI corresponds to the input voltage. The equivalent element R1 and R2, since they are in parallel, can be written in the form of a new element defined as R dash. Many of the books are notifying this equivalent as RB also. So when I go for the calculation of input impedance, the value of R dash is R1 parallel R2 as discussed, and the ZI value will be R dash parallel with beta RE. The output impedance can be written as RC parallel small RO. If the small RO is very, very large, it can be neglected and your ZO will be approximately equal to RC. The value of your voltage gain AV will be VO by VI, which will be equal to minus of RC parallel small RO by small RE, where if the RO is very, very high, even that will get neglected and we will land up at minus of RC by small RE. The current gain, as discussed, will be a ratio of I0 by II, and the I0 by II term can be modified in terms of a current divider rule. So when we go for the current divider rule, we have to go for the current chain rule to get a relation between I0 and II. So we have I0 by IC, IC by IB, and IB by II. And when you represent it, you will land up at beta into R dash into small RO. The whole thing gets divided by a factor RO plus RC into R dash plus beta RE, which can be estimated further as per our approximations. If I try to analyze the same thing using the HPI model, so HPI model will have input impedance represented by RPI and the input voltage as VBE or VPI. The current source will get modified into GM VPI or GM VB. The output representation will still remain RO. The output side will have a resistance defined as RC, and the input side will have a resistance RB, which is basically the equivalent of R1 parallel R2. So when I get the value of VO, the VO value is the value of current into the impedance. The current is GM VBE into the impedance value, which is RO parallel RC, which is now represented as RL. So the value of VO is minus of GM VBE RL. The value of VBE is actually equal to VI, that is my VPI. So when I take a ratio of AB, when I take a ratio of VO by VI to represent the value of AB, the value lands up at minus of GM RL, where RL is basically small RO parallel capital RC. If I neglect the impact of small RO, because the RO is considered to be very, very high, you will land up at the value of AB as minus of GM RC. Again, if you observe, either of the cases, when you try to solve using the RE model, the hybrid model, or the hybrid pi model, you will land up at actually the same value. In the previous scenario, when we have solved the same thing using the RE model, we got the equation as minus of RC by small RE. So GM is basically corresponding to 1 by RE. GM is the conductance and RE is the resistance. So inverse of resistance will land up at conductance. So overall, if you see, the value of minus of GM RL is going to be equal to the value of AV that we have found out in the previous case. In either of the cases, you will land up at the same value of the voltage gain. The significance of the minus sign, as discussed, it is corresponding to a inverting amplifier. So this is how you try to analyze a transistor in terms of model. As I have said, that whenever we try to go for the analysis of the amplifier, the entire analysis of the amplifier is split up into two parts, the DC analysis and the AC analysis. The rule for DC analysis is all the capacitors will work like open circuit. The voltage source will be short circuit. Whatever is left out, that is your DC equivalent circuitry. Whenever we go for the AC equivalent circuitry, the first thing is, during the AC analysis, the first step is the DC battery will be gone from the circuitry. All the capacitors will work like short circuit, but a device will come into picture with the help of its equivalent model. And once you go for the model circuitry, we will have to go for calculation of input impedance, output impedance, voltage gain, and current gain. So this is how you analyze a common emitter amplifier, and it is independent of the model analysis that we go for, because all the model analysis on estimation will approximately give you the same results. Thank you.